Hey team, okay, so I have been listening to webinars and recorded calls and all sorts of things on goal setting and putting together your goals for the next year. So I wanted to share a few of the things with you and create sort of a quick Cliff Notes version, if you will, to goal setting. Okay, a few things to keep in mind, and then I will sort of break it down for you. Few things to keep in mind is that you are going to want different types of goals. Mainly on this video, we're going to be talking about your business goals because that's who I am to you as your coach. But you will also want to incorporate other parts of your life, you know, with your family and your hobbies and that kind of thing. But a few of the business type goals that you will want to set are a summit goal. So that when you get to Summit, even if you are not able to attend Summit, that's just a good benchmark mid-year, a Summit goal, what you want to have achieved by Summit. You'll want to set a rank goal, an income goal, a personal development goal, and then also your own health and fitness goal. So where do you want to be by the end of 2015? You may want to have completed a certain number of workout programs. You may want to have done the ultimate reset, you know, those sorts of things. Or you may want to get through the year injury free or lose a certain number of pounds. Okay, so those are a few types of goals to keep in mind. There are a few secrets to goals and setting them that high achievers always have, okay? So the first one is that you have to believe that you can win. Most people, of course, think that other people have a higher education, or they just know the right people, or they're in the right place, or they're more intelligent, or they have this, or they have that. No, that's not the case. You have to know that you can win this, and you have to know and believe in yourself that you can accomplish your goals. The next thing, the next secret is that those high achievers have learned how to process failure. So they know that it's just part of it. They will get over the failure quicker. They welcome the failure even because they know that it is one step closer to them getting to where they want to be. The next secret is that they set very specific goals and they need to be very measurable. So instead of saying, I want to lose weight, you're going to say, I want to lose 35 pounds by December 31st. That's very specific and it's very measurable. They also know that they've got to get started now. And so you can set the goals, but if you procrastinate, then it's not going to do you any good. So part of that is breaking the goals down into bite-sized pieces so that you will actually gain traction and get going. I thought this was a really great quote for the last one. The last secret is that high achievers know their why. And Michael Hyatt's wife, Gail Hyatt, said that people lose their way when they lose their why. I was like, I love that. It's just said very nicely. Okay, so what we're going to do is first you are going to write down three limiting beliefs. So here are mine, and then what you're going to do is actually replace those with a liberating truth. So write down what you thought, what your habit of thinking is, and then write down what the actual truth is. So for example, one of mine is, no matter what I do or how I eat, I always look the same. So that would be the belief that is limiting me in my head. What I've replaced that with is people who eat clean and train mean over a long period of time get results. Okay, so those are that's an example. So you gotta do three. So go ahead and pause the video and do your three. Your future does not equal your past. Your past does not equal your future. Two different things. So think of 2015 as being a completely blank slate. And the more that you have had failures, the more you can learn from those. So don't worry about the past. What I'd like you to do now is to write out maybe 6 to 10 goals for the year. So go ahead and pause it. Write out your goals quickly. It doesn't have to be, very perfect. We're going to come back to them. Okay, so now what I'm going to have you do is go back to each of those goals and write out why it's important to you to reach that goal. You need to know what's going to happen when you achieve it, and you also need to know what's going to happen if you don't achieve that goal. You have to know your why for each one of those goals, okay? So go ahead and pause it and get that done. And then what you're going to do is to break down each goal into bite-sized chunks. And that may need to be done on a separate paper. You may have, a notebook that has each goal on a page and then a list of 100 action items that will go into creating that one goal. But here's a word of warning. Don't feel like you have to have every step written out before you take action on that item. All you need to know is a few steps in advance to take action on that goal. Don't wait until you have all the pieces put together to start. You just have to see a couple of steps in front of you, and then you'll see those couple steps further. And when you get there, you'll see a little bit further, and so on and so forth. So as long as you have maybe 3 steps written out for each of the goals, then you can have some traction and you can start taking action on those goals. So the more though that you just dump your brain out and put those tiny pieces down on paper, that'll help you in the long run so that you can grab one and do that day. And then the next day you can grab a little piece more and keep working toward that goal. All right, so basically here's the thing. You've come to a fork in the road. And you've got to decide which way you're going to go. You can give up, you can go it alone, or you can actually use the tips that I've given you and put them into place and get to your goal, to where you want to be in life. Hope that helps a little bit. Let me know as you do these steps if it was helpful and what your goals are. I would love for you to share that on the team page. I will be doing that with you for myself as well. So have a great day.